Thanks for joining me here on WMUR's Weather on the Web. I'm meteorologist Bill Gile, and we are going to be seeing some extreme heat continuing through the next several days, right through the weekend, in fact. So a few tips for you to help beat the heat. Best ideas, wear light-colored clothing if possible, and basically lightweight clothing, and also do what you can to limit your exposure to the sun. Now, a lot of activities take place for kids' camps during the course of the heating of the day, the maximum of the central part of the day. If you can change those to the morning or the late afternoon and evening, those are the best times. But otherwise, if you happen to be working outdoors, make sure you have plenty of breaks planned, you have plenty of water available, and if you just happen to be out and about and you need some relief from the heat, well, shopping malls, movie theaters, some good places to go. All right, also, like I said, drink plenty of non-alcoholic fluids. Water, the best thing. Also, make sure you do not leave your kids in the car. If you happen to run a quick errand and you say, I'm only going to be gone for a minute, make sure you take the kids with you. Think of that as $1 million sitting in your car exposed, and you do not want to leave it alone for sure. Also, the pets, do not go anywhere with you in these hot, humid conditions as well. And one final thing for infants, if you have little ones that you strap into a car seat, make sure you check those metal belt buckles if they have them. They can be extremely hot, so you want to cool those off first. And also, check on the elderly. Make sure your neighbors are doing just fine as well. Boy, hot temperatures continue all across the country again for today, and we continue to get our heat flowing right up from the Gulf of Mexico. Everything has just been feeding in our direction. There's basically been a stationary frontal boundary out in here. It was on top of us earlier in the week, but now Bermuda high pressure area has been pushing in towards the coastline, so it essentially has shoved all the heavy rains off through the Ohio and Tennessee valleys. But you can see how everything continues to flow out of the south and come right up towards the northeast. So we'll continue to get the scattered shower and thunder shower threat, mainly mid and late afternoon in the heat and humidity, but nowhere near as much as we had been getting. So overnight tonight, it will become mainly clear. There are a few evening showers and thunder showers that have to race on through, especially central and northern areas, but once they're gone, that's about it for the night. 65 to 69 for your overnight lows up north, some low 70s in southern areas with patchy fog. Then for tomorrow, here we go again, hot, humid conditions. I mean, very hot, 90 to 96 degrees southern New Hampshire. It'll be even close to 90 in many areas to the north. But once again, the pop-up shower or thunder shower can't be ruled out completely, but the threat looks to be perhaps a little more minimal. And then that dies off again in the evening, and it's another warm, muggy night. Then we head into the weekend, and it's the same story all over again. Morning hazy sunshine, pop-up showers and thunder showers for the afternoon, 84 to 94 degrees, pretty much the same story. On Sunday, we're really not changing things around. So here's the recap as we go through tonight again. That scattered evening shower or thunder shower around, especially northern areas, then temperatures dropping back to the mid-60s for lows there. Otherwise, just a few clouds to mainly clear skies, central southern areas. Readings in the upper 60s, low 70s. And it's a hot one tomorrow. It's a cooker. We're into the low and mid 90s. Many areas, the humidity will make it feel close to 100 degrees. That's just how it'll feel. So make sure you take it easy. Temperatures stay in the 90s through the weekend. So that's a heat wave there, the way things are looking. And then as we get into Monday and Tuesday, a few more scattered showers and thunderstorms pop up to cool us back a little bit to the upper 80s. That's your latest forecast.